There's a new exhibit at Roger Williams Park Zoo that is sure to attract every guest. A special species will be displayed in New England for the very first time.
Meet the zoo's newest members, timber rattlesnakes.
There's many species of rattlesnakes out there, but it's the only rattlesnake that is native to the New England area. It's a protected animal, experiencing many threats in the wild due to, you know, habitat loss, overcollection for pet trade, illegal markets, just indiscriminate killing because, you know, venomous snakes are often perceived as being, you know, dangerous and can be dangerous if you don't know what you're doing.
This is a great step not only for the zoo, but for the whole state, you said, right?
Yeah, this is probably the only venomous snake you can come see in Rhode Island right now. We have three female timber rattlesnakes on exhibit.
And check out that rattle.
The snake will get a new segment to his rattle every time it sheds its skin. As the segments form, they basically hit against each other. They're kind of locked together, so as they hit each other, that's what makes that ch-ch-ch-ch-ch sound.
If you hear that sound, step back.
So if you encounter a rattlesnake, and if he sees you first, he's going to not make a move and hope you don't see him. If he feels as though he's been exposed, then he's going to shake that rattle and say, get away from me. I don't want to have to bite you. I don't want to use my venom. Last resort is a bite.
They may seem scary, but they're highly important creatures.
So not only rattlesnakes, but all snakes in general are very valuable parts of our ecosystem as far as rodent control. They themselves are food for other animals. A lot of birds of prey rely on snakes and eat snakes.
Sadly, numbers are dwindling. Even humans pose a threat by collecting these snakes or running them over.
Road mortality is a huge issue for a lot of reptiles and amphibians. They just can't beat the cars. We've got populations where there could have been 100 snakes that we see, you know, 6-7 animals left in those populations. It's that drastic of loss in individuals that we're seeing.
Helping these shrinking populations may take a while.
For females, it takes up to 7 years for them to be mature enough to actually reproduce. Female timbers can give birth every other year, sometimes every 3 years.
So the zoo is trying its best to protect these creatures from becoming endangered.
So yeah, we're really happy about the snake den and to be able to hopefully educate folks about this amazing part of our ecosystem that we often goes unseen here in New England.
Unseen by many, but not Lou. Do you like being known as the snake guy?
I have been since I was 10, so I'm pretty used to it. No, I do. It's an animal that I'm very passionate about and will continue to be passionate about. And it's great to be able to be in a position now where I can actually use the resources of this amazing zoo here to help do something for our wild populations.
Nice guy. Now, in New England, the timber rattlesnake is considered to be state endangered. In addition to their animal predators and humans, many of these snakes now face a dermatitis problem that causes deterioration to the face. The snake den opens this Saturday. For a link to Roger Williams Park Zoo's website, just head to the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.